When I release a breakdown on a new cartridge, like the 22 ARC, I'll put a link to that new video up here if you want to check out this really excellent new cartridge. One of the comments that I'm always going to get is, why do we have these newfangled cartridges? My granddaddy's old 30-06 can do anything that I want, dadgum. Well, there actually are some really good reasons why these new cartridges keep popping up. Okay, part of it is, yes, these companies are trying to stay relevant, they're trying to stay fresh, and yes, of course, they're after money, they're a business, but no, it's a lot more than that. There really is a lot of passion behind a bunch of these cartridges for really good reason. So this is your limitation that we're all dealing with. This is a bullet catalog from 1972, I think. My father-in-law gave this to me. This is the Spear catalog. And as you can see, there's kind of a theme running through all of these. We have very inefficient to kind of okay to somewhat inefficient. These bullets just aren't the new hotness that we have out there right now. And if you are dealing with, you know, a deer or a hog at medium distances, then no, you can use those and it's going to be just great. However, if you want to be able to more easily get on target out at much longer distances, if you want to be able to stretch out and be able to have more energy when it arrives, then you kind of got to get into these new bullets. So we have these that have a completely different shape on the ogive. They have boat tails. They might have the plastic tips like you see on like the ELDM bullets. These are things that are going to improve the ability for that bullet to fly through the air accurately, reliably, to be able to keep that speed and be able to make a decent hit at longer distances. That's the first reason why we get these new cartridges. So for example, if I wanted to compare a couple of hot rod 22s, like 22 ARC versus 22 250, 22 250 or 220 Swift, those have been around for a very long time. 220 Swift really is the king of speed. Those get things moving out really, really fast, faster than you're gonna get from 22 ARC, but there is a difference in how they're developed. Back in the day when 220 Swift and 22-250 came out, they were based around small, squat, kind of fatter bullets like you see back here. In fact, some of these would have been loaded up in those cartridges. And at closer distances, they do move out really fast and you get a flat trajectory. But if you can get into heavier bullets that are longer, then you can actually fight the wind better and you can start to stretch out your distances. 22-250, fast as it is in a sprint, is not a long distance hauler. And that's why we get 22 ARC. This is a cartridge that is built to handle those bigger, longer bullets and to be able to not jam things up in the rifling and to be able to handle the twist. A lot of the time with your 22-250 rifles, you're going to have a very long twist rate, like 1 in 12. This requires a 1 in 7 for these big heavy bullets. So even if you think, okay, I'll take 22-250, I'm gonna load up a big heavy bullet for it, can't do that. It's not gonna work. You're gonna need a custom barrel. And yeah, you'll definitely need a custom barrel and it's not going to fit into a lot of magazines that you have out there. So we get into reason number two. This is developed to fit inside this. So this is the most common rifle that's being sold right now, the AR-15, and if you want to fit into this, you need a special cartridge. 22-250 won't do it unless you get into one of the weird ones like the Olympic Arms, I think it's the UMAR, I think it's called, or you know, you need to get into something bigger and heavier like an AR-10 for a cartridge like that. But if you want it to actually fit into the magazines and just run in this rifle as it is, all you need is a barrel swap and bolt head swap and yeah, that new magazine, then you can do this and you can't do some of the others. This is really good for those of us that, you know, I talked about in the last video, how we have a 223 rifle, but we've started to hit its limitations. We can only reach out so far to be able to reliably get on target, say in shifting winds, like you have a 15 mile an hour crosswind and things are kind of moving all around. 223 is a little bit harder to get on target as you get out to 600 yards and beyond. And you're not gonna have enough energy to really do all that much once you get there. Once you get into heavier bullets like 6mm ARC or 22 ARC, then yeah, you're not only able to get on target a lot more easily, but then once it arrives, it's gonna be able to do more damage. So reason number one, we have these new, more efficient bullets. Reason number two, we're trying to expand the capabilities of an existing platform. Reason number three is that we're trying to get some kind of special effect. 300 AAC blackout or 338 arc, 8.6 blackout. These cartridges are designed to run subsonic, for example. And so in order to fit into a certain rifle platform, like the 8.6 black, I think has to go into, it can fit into an AR-10 platform, anything that's kind of short action. And fitting within that platform and within those magazines, you can get that subsonic effect. Reason number four is going to be some kind of radical technology shift. The two cartridges that pop to mind are 6.8 Sig Fury or 7mm Backcountry. Both of these take your standard rifle that can only handle pressures of 62,000 PSI, but through changing the case metallurgy, you can get up to 80,000 PSI, so you can have a shorter rifle, and you can, with this new high pressure, be able to melt your rifling a lot faster. I mean, you can get out to longer distances and have higher speeds and get more energy on target with that. And yes, it will melt your rifling a lot faster. So yeah, if you got money, go ahead for one of those too. Now, the first thing that I want to say is that you don't have to jump onto these new bandwagons. If the dude next to you is shooting one of these new ARC cartridges and you've got your piddly little 223, if you guys are shooting at 200 yards and, you know, having a good time, it doesn't matter at all. If you're varminting, it probably doesn't matter. But if you have found that you've gotten to the limitation of one of the cartridges that you have, take a look at some of the new stuff. It might be able to stretch out what you have, just like we have with 223. If 223 is not doing it for you anymore, if you've been able to, you know, get into longer territories, you want to be able to make longer distance hits, or you want to be able to take your existing rifle and make it have a harder hit on larger game, then look at something like 22 ARC. But yeah, don't feel like you have to throw out your grandpappy's old 30-06. That thing is still rocking, and those old rifles tend to be really, really accurate as well. So buy in if you want, buy in if you need those extra capabilities, but whatever you got, just get out there and shoot, get better at what you have, and I'll be seeing you out there on the range.